out of San Antonio. It was this year has been a little bit of a rough start in the beginning, but you know, we had a victory, amen. And what it does is builds, it makes this church stronger. So we're going through it, but we're going to overcome it, amen. We found a good fishing hole. We like to go down to the flea market. There's a lot of young people down there. We're able to witness to them and tell them about Jesus. We've had some fruit come out of that, and we'll continue to work with that fruit. Let them know that, you know, we got those Christians sometimes, you know, they want to test the water. We're trying to get them just to dive. You know, no testing. Just dive into the truth. Amen. Hallelujah. So we're doing this. Amen. We had a lady. Her name was Kim. She came in our church, and she came in. She got made saved. She was on her and her daughter came in one night. They looked like they were on drugs, and this was on a Sunday night. Prayed for both of them. They wanted to pray. They started crying and all that, and gave all the, you know, did everything. Prayed for her. She got, you know, rooted into the church. She started coming more, and then just coming more and more. And then all of a sudden, they tell her she's got cancer on her leg. She comes in one morning, and she's telling about this cancer. And she's pastoring, and she's crying. And the doctors have already told her they're going to start chemotherapy, and what they're going to do, and how they're going to be able to take care of it, and all that stuff there. And so that night, I asked her that morning, I said, Kim, do you believe that Jesus Christ is your Savior and your healer? Yes, I do. I said, okay, then let's pray. Pray for her. I sort of put your hand where the cancer was at. I put my hand on her hand and prayed against it. Amen. She came in the following Sunday. She came in that morning. Before I could even finish the announcement, she's jumping up. Pastor, I'm healed. I'm healed. I said, okay, come on up to the front, Kim. Let us know what's going on. So she was healed. Amen. She's continued to have an assault coming against her. So she had to move from where she was at, and so we have not seen her, but my wife still, you know, talks to her here and there, so she's going to come back, amen. We're believing and trusting, amen. Also, we had two brothers. We had my brother Rudy, who came in church, and, you know, he was a man, he just inspired me. He was a man who knew the Bible very much, very, very well, and came in here. He was looking for a Holy Ghost preaching church. And this man knew the Bible. I mean, he knew it in and out. And he said, you know what, it's not about what you know in the Bible, it's what you have in your heart, and you got the Holy Spirit, man. He said he came in and he got rooted in the church. He came in, he just fell in love with God. The night before, on a Wednesday night, I preached on salvation, and he was the last one at the altar after we had already closed up the service. He was still at the altar that night, on a Wednesday night. We went to the other room. We were eating pizza over there, and he was still at the altar. He said, "Where's Rudy? He's over there at the altar." His wife, a very, very, very great woman, came in, and the next day, he goes to be with Jesus. Amen. But he got that first love back again. He fell in love with Christ again. And you know, that's what I see that in the... And I see my brother-in-law came in too, got rooted, wanted to play the guitar, wanted to do all these things for God and stuff. And you know what? He's doing it now. He's with Jesus, amen. He's on that group right now. So, you know, I got to see these things, and you know what? I was trying to figure out, man, what am I doing wrong? I see people coming in, people leaving, and you know, what am I doing wrong? And then I see Jeremiah, so it's in Jeremiah 3:15 that God's going to send a man, a pastor. He just sent them so that we can be able to help the people and to be able to guide them when there's things going on, that somebody's going to be able to help them through this time. That we're there to help them get to that place. And that's our job, is to make sure that, you know what, to be able to condition them, to keep them on that right path. And you know what? And I got to see these things. You know, we see testimonies that we see God's continued move. We had a lady named Lucy came in. She had these assaults were coming against her, and my minutes went up. Hey, Jack, thank you.
Before my minutes go, I just want to thank Pastor and Liz, and for all that they do, this congregation, for supporting us. Amen. We have great pastors here. Amen. Don't we? Praise God. Amen. God has blessed us. Me and my wife Rebecca, we pioneer a church in Southwest Austin. Sandwich in between Stasny and William Cannon Garment. I'll chew up my minutes, so chill out, all right? And then we got to, I'm just kidding. You can clap. Go ahead. Start clapping. Praise God. Amen. So what's powerful is that we got to really gear our church up to contribute, to send me to go to Sri Lanka with Pastor Wacker, amen, or Evangelist Wacker, amen. And so our church was involved in that, amen. And so they were excited about it. We talk about it every service, amen. We're going to go, I'm going to Sri Lanka, amen. And so we were praying for that congregation. We took as much video and pictures as we could. I brought it back. We had a fellowship. We showed them the videos and the pictures, amen. And we got to talk about it. And it was a wonderful time. It was a great time for them to be able to see that we're a part of something much bigger than just in this tiny little building, amen. That God is doing something, amen. So it was really, really exciting for them to see that. Amen. We've had, since conference, we had a revival with Pastor Gabriel Alonso, amen. It was a powerful time in God. God really spoke to some people. We only had one service with missionary Jesse Cluck, but he came a Sunday night and gave us a powerful word, amen, and began to call people out, amen. And so I was gearing them up, telling them, listen, man, you got to come tonight. God's going to speak. This man ministers in the gifts, and so you don't want to miss it. And so he gave some very, very timely words, was reading their mail, and then I know they were looking at me like, Pastor, that's messed up. You told him about me. And I was like, man, I promise you, I didn't say anything. This is God. God is, you know, God is trying to help you. And so it was powerful for them to be able to see supernatural things like that happening, amen. And so we've been seeing a lot of open hearts, amen, during outreaches or door-to-door outreaches, amen. And so the outreaches have been fruitful, amen. And so South Austin is whoo, I tell you what, amen. People slam the door in your face, and you just get used to it. And then that's why you come there, and you're like, oh, you want to hear about what we have to say? Praise God. Hallelujah. Amen. And so it's exciting to see all that happen. We recently saw a couple come in and get saved, and then they're staying at the Salvation Army right now, amen. And but they're bringing people, visitors coming, amen. They're recovering drug addicts, and God is helping them. It's been really, really awesome, amen. So I've been dropping them off there, and you know, I almost got mugged a couple times, and you know, I had to let them know what's up, amen. I locked my doors and I drove faster. But it's been powerful to be able to see people come in. These people are broken, man. People that are coming, they are broken. They are at the end of their rope. Amen. And all we have is the gospel. That's all we have. God loves you. God can change your life. Amen. So it's exciting to be a part of that. There was a guy that was one of my customers that was coming. He's a Stone Cone sinner. Amen. He's really? You serious? Oh my goodness. Holy moly. God is helping us, amen. So believe me, amen. This guy came, he from my job came, Cody and Corey knows him. He's just a sinner, man. Came in, got saved, got filled with the Holy Ghost, got baptized. I told them he came in, got saved. They were freaking out. Amen. So it's powerful to see what God is doing. Amen. So you pray for us, amen. God is moving. Amen.